No apology, Mr. President. You can bully those beholden to you to take the fall, but it was still false. And more, you're acting like something that we thought was just fiction. Quote, who controls the past controls the future. Who controls the present controls the past. That's from George Orwell's 1984. This president wants to control the present by having people change the past, backing up fake 9/11 celebrations backed up by bogus accounts, fake crowd sizes with fake charts, fake descriptions of a fake brown menace. And now, what would be petty if it were not part of such a pernicious pattern? When George Orwell wrote this, it was fiction. Now it's just frightening. Here's where we are. Trump tweeted on Sunday, in addition to Florida, South Carolina, North Carolina, Georgia, and Alabama will most likely be hit much harder than anticipated. At the time, on Sunday, when he said it, it was not true. The path had changed. So at best, he was relying on old information. But the idea that he was briefed on Sunday that Alabama was still in major danger, look at it. Believe your eyes. Alabama was no longer threatened in any real way. Certainly not, quote, much harder than anticipated. The opposite was true. Within minutes, the National Weather Service of Birmingham, which is part of NOAA, pointed it out. Alabama will not see any impacts from Dorian. Then came the next page out of Orwell. The party keeps repeating 2 and 2 is 5. Trump repeated the lie over and over. He faked a map in the Oval Office. That's the Sharpie Gate. He forced the farce on other parts of the government. Tonight, a new NOAA press release, no name attached, says, quote, information provided by NOAA and the National Hurricane Center to President Trump demonstrated that tropical storm force winds from Hurricane Dorian could impact Alabama. Quote, the Birmingham National Weather Service's Sunday morning tweet spoke in absolute terms that were inconsistent with probabilities from the best forecast products available at the time. The NWS Employee Union president didn't take it lying down. Let me assure you, the hardworking employees of the NWS had nothing to do with the utterly disgusting and disingenuous tweet sent out by NOAA management tonight. Hashtag NOAA. Understandable anger. That anonymous NOAA statement, it's an argument that a tiny sliver of Alabama that wasn't in the hurricane cone with minimal potential to see tropical force winds makes it all okay. Look at the key at the bottom. It was 5 to 10%. He's just wrong. The same chance as the White House seeing high winds. Long Island, he didn't seem concerned about those possibilities, and he shouldn't have been. The facts are clear. The models on Sunday do not justify what he said Sunday. He won't say it was based on all old information or just wrong. But Dorian didn't threaten Alabama. He was wrong. He is wrong. And his people keep coming on and off camera to say, if you'll just let it go, he will too. No. And I will never apologize for calling out power when they abuse the same. What you ignore, you empower. And those who cover for this behavior are complicit. This is not just about the facts. He's dead wrong on those. It's about a fiction of Orwellian proportions. This president will say and do anything to protect himself and his interests, and that is a manifest abuse of power. What's worse, he'll do it to your face.
That map that you showed today looked like it almost had like a Sharpie.
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know.
He doesn't know? Really? He doesn't know who drew that? The Washington Post reports the president himself made the edit. He's playing you for a sucker. He believes if he tells you enough that he's right, it will no longer be wrong. Another quote from 1984. The first line, it was a bright, cold day in April, and the clocks were striking 13. How could that be? The result of those in power forcing people to believe things. The heresy of heresies was now common sense. Orwell made the premise an exaggerated sense of an authoritarian state, and yet much of what he saw as fiction is now in our face.